My name's Brittany. I'm 28 years old and I'm from Phoenix, Arizona. I first started to notice hair loss when I was about 25. I noticed more hair in the sink. I was brushing my hair, noticing more strands were falling out. And it was really taking a toll because I could feel myself literally losing my hair. Having hair loss as a young female is devastating. You're looking for answers in a world of revolving doors that you can't get a solid answer from the people that you trust the most. It really causes an insecurity because you're always wondering if people are looking at you, noticing that your hair is falling out, noticing that you're thinning on top. Is that a bald spot that I have back there that they're looking at? So it was hard for me to go on with a professional career without having to be sidetracked by my hair loss. When I first explained to my family that I was having hair loss, I told my oldest sister, and her reaction was, well, look at my hair. And she had extremely thin hair as well. She had thin temples, thin vertex, thin crown, very visible scalp. So after that, she said, look at mom. Mom had the same type of hair, very thin, very much visible of her scalp, and it wouldn't grow much in length. And so I started to look at my family and even my dad didn't have much hair either. And so it really came to the part where, is this something genetic or is this hereditary? Is this something that my family's always had? Because even my grandfather, he had the cul-de-sac to where he only had hair on the back of his head. So it really started to become predominantly clear that it was a genetic issue. When you typically hear about laser, it's usually laser hair removal. So of course I was a bit skeptic to hear that laser would actually help with my hair regrowth. When I started using the laser, it was very easy, but there was actually a time where I had to wait to see what the results would really be. And I think it's really about patience and knowing that there are treatments available and to actually seek professional help rather than going on the internet and self-diagnosing. Finally, finding an answer to hair loss and laser was probably the best feeling that I could have for my self-image, for my confidence, and everything that made me feel like who I was. Being compliant and consistent is the key to having a successful treatment. At first, like most people, when you see that it starts working, you want to stop it because you think that you're good to go. But really, this is an ongoing treatment. And the convenience of it is what makes it easier to stay consistent and compliant. The convenience of having the Capillus 272 was very nice because I could wear it at work when I was sitting at my desk. I could actually get up and walk around the office with it. I could wear it in the car if I needed to, if I had a ride that I knew would be 30 minutes. You know, even if I was just relaxing at home, watching my favorite sitcom for the 30 minutes, I could have the cap on just hanging out. It was very easy to use. I wish that laser was the first answer that I would have found. I think it would have saved me a lot of heartache and a lot of money, and just it would have helped me explain to my family, my friends, everything that was really going on with my hair and that I actually had an answer for it rather than feeling like my hands were tied behind my back and I just had to settle with the hair loss that I had. I think the best thing that I could recommend to someone is to be proactive about it. If you notice it, do something about it. Don't wait, because the longer you wait, the worse it can get. And by being proactive about it, you can actually stop it and help reverse it.